20% of them are relisting with the same agent, 70% aren't relisting at all, and only 10% are relisting with any agent, let alone whether it's you or the other 5,000 realtors in your area. So what I want to do in this quick video is show you how you can get expired homeowners to list with you, because it's a little bit different approach probably than what you're accustomed to. So you think expired homeowners are going to list with you? Highly unlikely. As a matter of fact, I want to show you some stats here that'll help you out. Evidently, my dog wants to be famous here today. Look at you, honey bear. Honey wants to be famous. If you're a real estate agent and you're looking to sell expired, get listings from expired homeowners, probably not going to happen. And I want to show you some stats here. 20%, this is some stats that we've compiled nationally. 20% of expired homeowners relist with the same agent they had it listed with before, whereas only 10% list with a new agent. Here's where those numbers make a difference for you. 70% of the homeowners do not relist their property. So if you're doing some marketing to expireds, if you're like calling them, emailing them, sending them a bunch of mail, maybe you have a 5 or 6 postcard campaign and a sales letter that you're sending out to them, 20% of them are relisting with the same agent, 70% aren't relisting at all, and only 10% are relisting with any agent, let alone whether it's you or the other 5,000 realtors in your area. So what I want to do in this quick video is show you how you can get expired homeowners to list with you, because it's a little bit different approach probably than what you're accustomed to. Now, here's how this works. If you were to call them, your script is no good. Hey, I was just calling to see if you were still thinking of selling your home. Are you guys interviewing realtors? I'd like to interview for the job. All of those things that you're asking. You know why they're not relisting? Why 70% of them are not putting their home back on the market? They lost the home that they wanted to move to. No longer have a need to move. Right? We were in contract on a new construction home, didn't sell our home in time, so we lost our new construction home. We no longer want to sell. Well, that's good information for you to know, right? We were going to get a relocation over to the other side of town. We didn't want to deal with the downtown traffic, so we were going to move over there, but the relocation deal fell out because we couldn't sell our home. That's good information to know. So the fact is, if you're marketing to expireds, here's the big training for you here. I don't want you to market to them about how you can sell their house anymore. I want you to market to them about how you can find their next house for them. The Dream Home Finder program. You've heard a lot about that if you've been through some of our videos on our Facebook page or YouTube channel or whatever the case is. Stop trying to get expireds to list with you, to relist their home using you as their agent. All you have to do is tell them you can help them in finding their dream home. I know you probably lost out on your new construction. I know you probably lost the home you wanted to move to. Whatever the case is, I can help you with finding the next home. If you can get them motivated again, they will in fact list with you. But those stats are astounding. 70% of them do not relist because they don't have a need to sell anymore. Their deal changed. Right? So your job is to get them re-motivated as a homeowner. If you can get them to fall in love with the next one, they'll divorce the current one, right? So if they fall in love with the new house, they're willing to let this house go and let it go at the right price. Because even those 10% that do relist, you know what we found? Statistically, it's overpriced. You know why? Because they're going to say, well, if we don't get our $480,000, we're not going to move at all. Let me have you fall in love with another house and watch how quickly you're willing to sell that $480,000 house for $460,000 or for $450,000 or whatever that number is, right? So what you'll want to do, and hopefully you're taking notes on this and you're really thinking through, you're not like Honey and decide to go to sleep on my lap here. She's bored by our expired marketing training, evidently. Hopefully you understand that when you're marketing to expireds, you just got to help them with finding their next house. You'll naturally get their current listing. I think you'll find that to be incredibly helpful with the marketing you do put out there. Stop talking about how you're the best marketer, you can sell their home, you can get it exposed to the best buyers, you're a better listing agent than the last guy. There's no need for it if they don't need to sell their car anymore or their house anymore. I was getting ready to use the analogy, like if I'm selling my car, it's because I want to buy that new model that just came out. If I go there and I can't get the price I want, or it's sold out, or you can't get the model for 6 months or whatever, I no longer want to sell my car, and I don't want to sell my car even if you'll give me $500 more than it's worth, right? I was selling it because I wanted to move up to something that made me feel better. So these homeowners are only moving to another house because that's a better move for their family. If they lose that opportunity, they don't want to sell this one anymore. Let's get them remotivated. Okay, so hopefully that's helpful for you. Get on our Wednesday training, closingseverymonth.com. My last Wednesday training completely crashed at the end of it. So we were giving away tons of free materials and sales letters and stuff. I was just like, give me your email address and I'll shoot it over to you. And the whole thing crashed. We had way too many people at once that were logging in. But anyway, start thinking about the niches you're marketing to. Are you marketing to expireds? Are you marketing to FSBOs? Are you going the right approach with them so that you can get them to favorably reply to you? And get yourself registered for the Wednesday webinar. Closingseverymonth.com will help you in getting that spot. I better go feed Honey here. She's ready to eat some dinner. This, when she starts taking my time, she doesn't want any loving. She wants some food. She's a lot like me. So anyway, start using that expired campaign. Let me know how I can help you. Make sure you like the video here. Follow our page. Lots of great information. If you guys have been through some of our videos here, try and teach you as much as possible and never ask you for a thing. Plenty of money to be had by all. Just start making some closings happen for yourself. Life gets really good. So have a profitable day. We'll talk to you soon, and bye-bye for now. Hey, I hope you enjoyed that video. And listen, we've got a lot more information for you to help you with growing your real estate business. We load new videos nearly every day, and I want you to have access. So you got to do two important things. It's both totally free. Number one, I want you to subscribe to this channel. You'll see the little subscribe button for you to click. If you don't have an account with YouTube, set it up. It's totally free. You got to subscribe to this channel. And the most important factor, you got to ring the bell. Right next to that subscribe button, you'll see a little bell to turn on notifications. That will let you know every time I load a new money-making video to help you with growing your real estate business. Subscribe and make sure you ring the bell. We'll see you in the next video.